We're here.
Who's ready for some clean Christian comedy? I come from a very Christian family. My dad's like Jesus Christ. I've waited my whole life for him to come back. There's a lot of white people in this room. Every time I hang out with white people, I do stuff I never normally do. Crazy stuff. Like, spend 15 bucks on a pretzel. I wish that was a joke. I did not know how I was gonna get home that day. I'm black and Asian. I love it because it's the best of both worlds. I got a black brain and an Asian ding dong. One time a girl shouted from the crowd, "Don't you mean Asian brain and black ding dong?" And I was like, "Bitch, you don't know me." It's confusing being black and Asian, especially when I'm shoplifting and I hear a voice in my head saying, "Hey, black man, hoodie, been black, black man, you black!" Did you know that you could flirt with a girl in front of her boyfriend and then steal that guy's girlfriend? My girlfriend's new boyfriend knew that. Sometimes in life you have a bad experience with a person of a race you're not familiar with, and then that one bad experience forms a stereotype in your mind. Like, now I think that all Jews are dudes who steal your mom from your dad and try to win you over with trips to Disneyland. That joke's about my Jewish stepdad. Mark Steinberg. When I first met my white dad, I knew I hated him. I just didn't know whether it was for the Korean War or the slavery. I can't finish my joke because he's enjoying it so much. Thank you. My mom, she left my black dad for my Jew dad because she thought he had money, but he didn't have any money. And the thing is, leaving a black dad for a broke Jew dad is like leaving a black dad for another black dad. My dad, I love my dad because he was a man of the Bible. Like, you know how Jesus turned water into wine? My dad turned all of our money into wine. My mom and my dad, things didn't work out, and, like, it makes sense, because they were just two totally different people. Like, my mom, she was a hardcore vegan, and my dad just really liked sleeping with other women. The funny thing about about my dad is, like, he left my family when I was 5, but unfortunately, he could only afford to move across the street. So, I had a bad dad, but an okay neighbor. He didn't come to baseball games, but he let me borrow sugar. The only way I could play catch with him was if my ball fell in his yard and he was just throwing it back. Did you say that's so sad? No, my dad's a cool guy, though. I walk next door, I talk to him sometimes. He mispronounces words. Like, instead of judicial system, he calls it the jiu-jitsu system. He's like, I don't trust the jiu-jitsu system. Darn jiu-jitsu system. Locking brothers up. I don't do cops, dude. Lawyers don't do jiu-jitsu. Or instead of invincible, he says invisible. So he's like, these darn cocky cops think they invisible. They not invisible. He'll be at the marches like, Black Lives Matter, cops not invisible. That's my dad, man. Manslaughter. That's an interesting crime. It's like when you murder somebody but you didn't mean to. Like, whoopsie-doo. I imagine the guy who committed manslaughters on TV, like, I say from the bottom of my heart to the families of the victim, whoopsie-doo. Public service announcement. Blacks, whites, and Jews, I'm cool with them, but there's one race that needs to get the hell out of my city, the marathon. This race needs to go back to hell where it came from, ancient Greece. This is the only race that invades my city and sets up a border that I can't cross. Cross the street, can't get to work. This race is taking our jobs. All right, you guys have been fun.